So right now, ladies and gentlemen, I got my guy on Zoom right now. You might have seen him. There's a new show out right now on Stars, and it's called P-Valley. And boy, do they do it down in the valley. Yo, I got my man Showtime Brando on the air. What's going on, Showtime?
What's up? How you feeling, my guy?
So, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't know my man Showtime Brando, Brando, let me just say this. Thank you, brother. Thank you for being on. My daughter loves the TikToks, and it was your video, your song that helped us out. Had a fat brother doing some work, but I tried. I kept up with it.
That's funny, man.
So what's going on, Showtime?
Look, man, life is good. You know what I'm saying? Just taking it day by day, you know, staying positive, staying creative, and making things happen. You feel me?
I feel you. So you are from New York?
Yes, sir.
I was about to say, you got to be from New York if you're doing Light Feet.
Yep.
So if you're the home of Light Feet is here.
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir. You from Harlem?
Not from Long Island.
You from Long? Oh, you live in Long Island.
Yeah, I'm Long Island.
You a 495 boy.
LIE.
Yeah, there you go. So Showtime, tell us a little bit about yourself.
You know, Brandon Gilpin is my full name. They call me Showtime Brando. You know, I'm a dancer, I'm an actor, I'm an artist. You know, I make music, you know what I'm saying? You know, I had you out here doing the Life Beat Challenge, you know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna get my asthma pump.
I really love creating content, you know, not only just content, you know, letting people know that they can do whatever they want to do in life, and you know, if you go full through with it, it'll work for you. And I'm also a Morehouse College student.
Wow. And you in college. So how old are you?
I'm 20.
You're 20 years old and you got all this. How'd you get the name Showtime?
It's actually very funny. I used to hoop, right? You know what I'm saying? I was on the court. I was out there, you know what I'm saying? And one of my friend's dad, every time he would see me on the court, he would always see me, like, you know, do tricks and stuff. I was one of those kids, you know what I'm saying? I was one of,
you know what that mean in English, right? In New York, when you do that, that means you a chucker.
Yeah, nah. I'm not bucking, sir. I was getting buckets, you know what I'm saying? And so every time he would see me, he'd be like, that Showtime right there. Showtime. And then I was like, I didn't really pay attention to it till I was like 15, and like I started like a dance team or whatever, and I was like, I wanted like a nickname and stuff like that. And I was like, oh, Showtime would be cool. So then I was like, all right, Showtime, and then, you know, took the N off my last, off my name, and then Showtime Brando.
That's a dope name though. Like, and I'm watching, like, I've been going back, looking at your videos, watching the growth of your dancing, especially your dance moves. First of all, brother, I got an issue with you with the dance moves. You got out there, look, I'm joking. Look, his face is like, what?
I'm like,
no, you're out there dancing in clogs, brother.
Crocs, yeah.
Crocs. I call them clogs, they call them Crocs.
I'm always, you know, Crocs up.
Rasheen, he pulled the Crocs out. He pulled the Crocs out. He got Crocs on right now, multiple color Crocs.
Crocs up, man. You know what I'm saying?
How many Crocs do you own?
A lot. You wouldn't want to know. Let me tell you.
So everybody, you try to hoop in Crocs too?
I mean, I have. you know what I'm saying? I don't know what, like, how it, like, really happened for real, but it was just like one day, like, I saw them, I was like, let me pick these up. And so I bought the black ones and I bought the green ones. And then I was just wearing them around school, and then I was like, I liked it, and then I started making my dance videos. I was like, all right, this will be different. And then I just started, and then it just continued. Like, everything, you know what I'm saying? So it was just like, I'm going to just keep doing this and be the Croc boy, because I really love Crocs. Like I really do. Like,
I can tell you had a full suit and Crocs on.
Yeah.
Everybody else had on sneakers and stuff and shoes. You had on Crocs. I was like, he wearing Crocs? But you did the damn thing. I got to give it to you.
You know what I'm saying? To get the job done.
So how did you get into dancing and music?
I started dancing when I was like 4 years old. I've been in dance lessons, you know, I've taken tap, ballet, jazz, hip hop, all that stuff, right?
All that. Multicultural.
I've been taking that since I was young. And then when I was, like I said, when I was 15, I was like, I don't want to work a 9-to-5, and I'm not going to, right? Because I worked at McDonald's, you know, and I was like, this is not it. Like, there's, you know what I'm saying? Like,
trust me, I know.
Like, this ain't it. So I was like, how could I, you know, mobilize and monetize, you know? So I was like, oh, I like to make music, you know what I'm saying? Like, I hadn't put out no music before, but, you know, I was always, like, you know, kind of musical, I guess.
Right.
So I was like, let me get in the studio. I made my first song, Ultimate Dance Challenge, and that song, that's my baby. Like, that's the first song I ever made, and I was just hyped, you know? So I was like, I dance, so let me just add some dance moves in it, and then boom, you know? And then it was successful for what it was, and then I was like, oh, I can continue to keep doing this, so I just did. And, you know, here I am. You know?
I'm too grown to be walking down the street talking about Showtime, Showtime. and I be dead doing it, though. My daughter be like, get it. And he be like this. Yo, so I've been watching this show, bro, P-Valley. First of all, have you ever even been to a strip club?
I actually haven't, still to this day.
And you sitting there watching all that ass?
Wait, hold on.
All right, before I start asking my crazy questions, right? how did you get the part?
So I have an agent and manager and all that stuff, right? I got the audition, right? I got the audition to be the DJ, and I auditioned for it like 4 times, you know, throughout from like November to February, right? Mm-hmm. Of 2018 to 2019, because we shot in 2020. We shot March 2019.
Okay.
I auditioned like 4 times throughout that period. And then, like, I got the call and I booked them. And I was like, whoa, like, oh, all right, cool. Yeah.
You never been to a strip club and got a strip show? Oh, like, come on. Like, have you ever DJed before?
And here's the thing about that, right? I've never DJed a party before, and I never had the interest to DJ a party before, right? But I've always hosted parties, right? So I would be on the mic 24/7 at every single party I was at, because I used to throw a lot of parties. I used to be at a lot of parties when I was in high school. You know, that's how I got my music out there. That's how I, you know, help people. You know, like, we just throw parties all the time in high school and in college. So I was always the one hosting it. Like, I was always the one on the mic, right? So, like, that part was literally just natural to me, right? But I never actually had the interest of actually physically DJing. And I saw, but I've been surrounded by DJs my whole life. So it was like,
DJ never scared. Yeah, he gonna try to take your job, Rasheem.
I'm thinking once this virus stuff is over, we get back to actually working. I think we need to bring him up here one day.
And battle?
Ooh. Not battle, but just bring him up here so he can host the party.
Ooh. I think we should have a DJ battle. DJ Brando versus the 914 King. Showtime versus the 914 King.
Let me tell you something. I would lose. I would lose.
I got confidence in you.
No, don't. Don't.
All right.
Hosting so battle. If we was having a hosting battle, now that's a different story.
I'll take you on that. I'll take you on that.
Ah, man. I know how to have confidence.
I am not letting nobody in Crocs beat me in no hosting battle.
Hey, you know what's crazy?
Funny. Now let's get back to P-Valley. You get the role, and you're 20. So you had to be about 19, 18.
I was 19.
So how do you explain to your mom or your dad, hey, I'm going to be a DJ at a strip club in the morning? Like, how do you say that?
It was very interesting. It was, you know what I'm saying, because when I initially came, like, so I was in Atlanta when I got the first callback. Right? Mm-hmm. And the first callback was in New York. So I had to fly from Atlanta to New York. Like, I got the call that I had to be there on Monday, and this was a Friday, right? Mm-hmm. So, it was like quick. It was like, they called me, and it was like, oh, yeah, we need you in New York on Monday. I was like, it's Friday. And it was Super Bowl weekend. Yeah. So, I was like, wow, like, hey, like, and it was actually my first callback as well. So, So I was like, Mom, I got a callback. She was like, what, you got a callback? And she was like, yeah, for what? I was like, remember that strip club DJ role? She's like, no, but tell me more. And then I was telling her what it was about. And then she was like, okay, tell the story. You know what I'm saying?
She said, okay.
Yeah, she ain't there. She didn't care. She didn't care. She didn't really care about you. Just like, you know what I'm saying? Don't come home with no babies now.
That's facts. So do you have the urge to go to a strip club after watching this?
You know, not really. You know, because like I feel like I've seen it all now. You know? Like,
Good way of thinking.
No, seriously, do you, if you see the show, like, they're literally doing it up there on the tricks, doing flips and all of this extraneous things. And I'm like, wow. And I get to witness this 20, like, 6-7 hours a day. I'm like, oh.
So you just sitting there watching the booty jiggle all day?
All day.
Like, he like a big kid. He'd be like,
like, this is one actually like screenshot that I have of like me. Like, it's mad funny. I'll send it to you later. It's like, it's just me like in the booth.
But let me ask you, do like Brandy and all of them, do they do their own stunts or?
It's a mix of both. Okay. Right. So like the real, like extraneous, like when she was up, like she, like they had, they like do, like they have some stunt doubles for like some things, and then like some from other ones, like they kind of do it themselves. And some of them were really adamant about doing it themselves, you know, because like, you know, embodying the real character. And then like there was just some things that they just couldn't do, you know, because like, God, you know, if something really were to happen, you know, like the, you know, they can't, you know what I'm saying, we mid show, you know, like we moved, like, you know, so there were certain limitations.
So my thing is, you watching this for 8 hours a day. How hard is it to have a conversation when somebody titties is in your face?
It wasn't like our cast is very family oriented, right? Okay. And the whole vibe of the set is very family oriented. The whole vibe of the show, as you can tell, is very family oriented, right? Like, even though we're not blood, but like, we still family. Like, everybody's really like, Uncle Clifford makes sure everybody's taken care of, you know what I'm saying?
So is he really like that off air? Like,
no.
Oh, you talking about on the show?
On the show. What do you mean? Like, is he really like family oriented on air?
Right.
Yeah, both definitely. Yeah,
Uncle Clifford. Holds it down on the show.
Holds it down. Clifford holds it down. Everybody holds it down. Katori Hall, an amazing creator. She really made sure like that was the vibe of the set. That was the tone. Mm-hmm. Like we all, it was a really comfortability thing because this is uncomfortable stuff, right? And so it was like, we're gonna make everybody comfortable. How are we gonna do that? We're gonna bond. We're gonna make sure we're all family. We wanna make sure we all feel comfortable doing, you know, whatever it is. And so yeah, like it was really I never really felt uncomfortable. It was kind of like, all right, cool. You know.
So when you need advice, who's the cast member that you would go to for advice?
So I never really seek advice, like per se, like, oh, I need advice, help me. It was more like they would give me advice all the time, 24/7. Uncle Clifford and Brandy, Nico and Brandy, they would literally come to me like every single day and like tell me words of wisdom every single day. And like even still today, we talk about it all the time. And Lil Murda, Jay Fonz, right? Like it was kind of like everybody, Katori, like I don't know, it was just like that. Like everybody was sharing knowledge all the time, you right. know? Like it was just like I could literally go to any single person. Parker, everybody, like literally, like. Yeah, it was just like that. Like it was real family. Like it was real. Like, yeah.
And it's crazy because I was watching another interview with you, and you basically said that your character plays, that the character that you play, DJ Never Scared, is a 15-year-old DJ from high school who gets into the strip club. And I'm like, what? How does a 15-year-old get a gig at a full-fledged strip club?
So that I can't explain to you how I got in there yet, you know, because that's all gonna, you know, you're gonna see throughout the seasons.
That has yet to be written yet.
Yeah, yet to be revealed. But Uncle Clifford understands that I really just want to DJ. Mm-hmm. And I really just want to work on my craft as a DJ and as, you know, as a producer, as we saw in episode 6. And I'm willing to do it. Like it's just a job. Like to DJ Never Scared is just a job. I'm trying to get some money like everybody else. You know, everybody got a hustle, you know?
And how close is your character? All right, watching all the characters now, it's a broad, different attitudes, right?
Yeah.
Who would you say in the cast is just like their character in real life?
Including me or
including you?
Well, I would say, to be honest, I would say me. Not just for the simple fact, of like DJ Never Scared is in high school and he goes to a prep school, right?
Right.
He goes to a prep school, all white prep school. Not all white, but like, you know what I'm saying. Most of the white kids go to the prep school, and then he DJs at night, you know. And then me, Showtime Brando, I'm Brandon Gilpin in the daytime, Morehouse College student, you know, and then I'm Showtime Brando, dancer, actor, all that extra extraneous things, you know? So right. that's where the parallels between our two worlds are kind of aligned. And that's why it's really like, that's why I would say I'm more like, I'm the most like my character. But other than that, I would definitely, Brandy, and Brandy and Uncle Clifford, I would say, come at a close neck and neck to me because Brandy and Nico. Why don't you call Uncle Clifford? Brandy and Nico, because Brandy's actually a dance teacher, right? And she's a dancer.
I remember her with the girl Lorianne. She used to dance with her.
Yeah. She's a dancer. She's a dancer and a dance teacher. Uncle Clifford and Nico, in a sense, were like that real family oriented kind of vibe. You know, really family oriented, really nurturing, taking care of kind of thing. And, you know, it's still on your ish, you know, still making things happen, you know?
This is dope because when I saw it, I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna watch this. Like, this is all about. And it's crazy because this is a story that probably needs to be told.
Yeah.
You know? And I always say this. I always make a joke. Me and Rasheen actually talked about it earlier today. When I go to the strip club, I spend $20. Right? I'm not trying to put anybody to college or to school. I'm there for a good time. The best stripper to me gets $8. I'm sorry. That's it. I got it proportioned very nice. Okay. Well, don't laugh. All right, I'm serious. $8 to the best stripper. Everybody else is getting a single. All right, and the bartender messed it up, right? So, what's next for Brando? Like, but matter of fact, before that, when you said you're in college, how do your classmates now treat you? Like, do they go, oh my God, I saw you on such and such? Like, what's the vibe?
So it's very, let me tell you, it's very interesting because I really haven't seen much of my classmates since March, right? And it's really weird, like, because some of them knew that I was filming the show because the sprinter van will come and pick me up, right? Okay. And so from school, and so there was that, you know, nobody like, you know, and more in the AUC, Morehouse, Spelman and Clark, like, celebrities aren't like a thing, you know? Right. What I'm saying, like, everybody, like, we have students from, you know what I'm saying, celebrities' kids, all of that stuff, you know.
They go right past you, like, yeah. Like,
yeah, you know, like, so that's kind of like nothing. And nope, so, and all my friends, you know, everybody's like, oh, yo, keep grinding, you know, keep hustling, keep doing your thing, proud of you, all that stuff. So that's pretty much how that vibe goes. But, like, I haven't really been on campus. I haven't really seen anybody since March. And March was, I went on vacation. And High Maintenance on HBO, mm-hmm. a show that I did came out in March, right? And then once that show came out, it's like everything closed after that, right? Everything was shut down, right? And so then, like, I didn't see anybody that wasn't on campus, but I went back to get my stuff, and one of my friends was like, yo, like, I'm proud of you. I remember seeing you grind. And that's kind of what it is, because everybody who knows me from school, you know, because I was popular around campus, like, they know, like, I've been hustling for, like, right. a long time. You know what I'm saying? They always, you know, share my stuff, support my stuff and all that. Yeah, it's always like, wow, like, I'm proud of you. Like, you really made it. You really, like, made it happen kind of thing. Like, and you know, you've been wanting this since freshman year, since we met right. you.
So you got anybody that's, like, phony that comes out of the woodwork? So, you know, they come out heavy.
Not
hey, Brandon.
Not really, because I was never that kind of person. I guess, like, I never had that, like, never really had that energy towards me in the negative way. Like, nobody really showed, like, that I know of, nobody really showed me fake love. You know what I'm saying? Nobody really put me down and say, you're not going to make it kind of thing. You know, not explicitly, but, like, nobody really does that. Like, I don't know why, like, I don't get that. Like, nobody does that to me. You know, I don't feel like people don't do that to me because
I call you and be like,
hey, Brandon, what you got on? Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, sweetheart. That's different.
No, like, yeah, everything kind of, everybody's cool. Everybody's, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I think I'm grateful for that because I put out that kind of energy and I don't, like, tolerate other types of energy. Like, I don't even, like, pay attention to it. So it's like, I don't really see it.
Do any of the guys in your family be like, yo, when you go back for season two, I need to be there with you?
Yeah, my cousin's like, yo, put me on with this person, put me on Mississippi, put me on with Ellery, put me on with Brandy. I want to.
Listen, that Mississippi, that
in my quick letter I, humpback,
ain't no joke, player. She about to take Mercedes' whole job.
That's funny.
But it's good to see, like, you're young, 20, and starting and doing good in the industry. Like, what's next for you?
So, what's next for me? Woo! I got an EP coming out maybe by the end of September. We still working on it. It's Caribbean. All Caribbean vibes because I'm Jamaican. Yeah, I had a Caribbean record come out last year. It's kind of getting some traction now, you know, because of the show and because of other stuff I got going on. I had that record come out. And so I'm gonna put out a full EP with all vibes because I'm just feeling vibes. You know what I'm saying? Right. I'm feeling vibes and that's the type of person I am. When I want to do something, I do it. You know, I'm not gonna wait. I'm not gonna figure out if I really wanna do it or figure out if it's the right decision. I'm just gonna do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever happens with it. You know?
I know you said you're Jamaican. Is your parents, like, Jamaican? Like, I'm talking about Yardy Jamaican.
Yeah, born and raised. Both
Woo!
Of them.
Yeah. That mean they get into your ass.
Yeah, I'm first generation.
Your daddy do the foot to the front and lean back and be like, listen, boy. Yo, man, they come across your face, you know.
Oh, dad.
But, yo, it is so dope, like I said, to see you. And if people don't know, you guys already got a deal to sign for season two, which is a real dope thing. So I applaud that.
Thank you.
And you only what? We only what, 6 episodes in right now?
Yeah, we got it after episode 3.
After episode 3?
Yeah.
Yeah, you really like Mercedes.
Yeah.
Listen, let me tell y'all, for all those who don't know, Mercedes is supposed to be the OG stripper. No, she is the OG stripper.
Yes.
Her and her mama got problems.
What the hell is going on? I've been praying all day on this. I've been praying all my life, in fact. And today, he finally showed me the way.
Ma, we ain't got time for your motherfucking sermons now. Why are you coming out of my gym?
This gonna be my church.
You stole all my money?
Well, God showed me the way.
They got problems. Like, she's a preacher, trying to be a preacher. And she goes to a church and the male dominance is in that church and they don't want her preaching because they say there's no place for a woman.
Yeah.
And then Mercedes she saved over $20,000 to buy a gym for her dance team. And she was supposed to quit stripping. So it was leading up to Mercedes' last dance.
Yeah.
And the day of her last dance, her and her mama out in the street acting a fool, fighting.
Oh, God.
But here's my question. What do you guys think if your mama stole your money and bought your property that you wanted to buy your gym, what goes down? DJ Rashin, you first, because you got a look in your eye.
I got a look. That's my mom.
So she can just take your money and buy the church?
Listen, she did a whole lot for me, so.
So you ain't mad. You saved all your money. And
she stole it. She stole it.
She stole it. She ain't asked you, bro.
You asked for it, and she stole it.
Right. You gave her money to hold, and the day you say, yo, I'm buying this property, and she says, I'm going to get the check for you. And she takes your money.
I think we have a problem.
That's what I'm asking you. What do you do?
We have a problem.
She takes, not only does she take your money, she takes your money and buys the building that you were going to buy.
Facts.
Oh, we got to go to court.
You going to court?
We're going to court.
Mercedes waxed that ass.
You can't go to court. Let me tell you why you can't go to court.
Because you, yeah, the money was being washed. Like, she was using it to put in the fund for her.
Yeah.
So, basically, it's nobody's name on the money.
Yeah. And the building was up for auction, so anybody could grab it whenever.
Right. What do you do, Brando?
Yeah. Wait, look,
before you answer, look around, make sure your mommy and daddy ain't around.
I ain't gonna hit her now. You know. I ain't gonna do all of that. Well, let me tell you something. That building will not be used for whatever she intended to be.
I guess it's gonna be burnt to the ground.
Yes,
unofficially burnt, but you know, burnt.
I'm not even gonna burn it. You're not walking into my building. Like, I'm sorry, you're not.
Especially, you bought it for a church. You're supposed to be holy.
Yeah.
Five. And you stole my money and said it was for Jesus?
Jesus. Jesus said there ain't no, supposed to be no stealing. And you gonna steal it?
You know what they say about people that go to church.
I ain't. Listen, you ain't
getting me. We're gonna be there for another.
You ain't getting me in trouble with that one. Yo, Brando, you got any more dance challenges coming up?
I got a few in mind. I got a few I'm working on. I've been in the studio, you know, cooking up.
Make sure it's fat friendly.
It's gonna be fat friendly. Don't worry, it's gonna be everybody friendly.
I'm mad at Brando because, first of all, he ain't even said, you ain't fat, bro. He just went, it's going to be fat friendly. Like,
no, I mean, you ain't fat. You just, you know.
I'm not fat. I'm just fluffy, right?
Yeah, big boned.
Brando, when I see you outside in these streets, I'm like, hey, Brando. Hey, bro. So, everything is going good for you, and it's good to see during this quarantine that you are able to pull off what is difficult in the industry right now, and that's make money, because this industry is being held back from money. I know, because I was away for 6 months and thought I was coming back to some cheddar change, and I ain't getting out a dollar.
Look, it's an unfortunate thing. And here's the thing. Here's the thing, like, that helps, like, you know, people, like, you know what I'm saying? Because obviously, like, if it wasn't, I'd be making more money, you know. But like, you gotta find other avenues, and everyone else, you're not alone in this.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. if it was just like, you know, like, and that's what I think helps people sleep at night, is like, you're not the only one suffering. You know what I'm saying? Right. So yeah. But
this is the time that we take ourselves and reinvent.
Yeah,
you know,
reinvent.
You gotta reinvent. And that's just basically what it is. You know, I think it was just time for everybody to get themselves together.
Yeah.
This was a wake-up call and time to reinvent. You're well-grounded.
Yeah.
You know, I thought you were going to be like a hype, preppy, like, ooh, like you just, I thought you were going to have like an ADHD attitude. But you're really, yeah, not like that. Because the way you dance and stuff,
yeah,
it's like always on 10.
Yeah.
So I thought you was going to be on 10, but you really like mellow.
Yeah, well, I think that mellowness came within the last year, because I'm really on 10, 90% of the time. But
so you fronting right now?
No, I'm not. I just, I mastered the art of being who I need to be when I need to be it.
There you go.
I genuinely, and obviously I'm still learning that, but I think I got a really good hold on it. You know, I got, you know, going to Morehouse, you know, still being like, still like a, like, I'm like a kid still, you know what I'm saying? Like, I play a kid, and so, like, I'm always on 10 then, and you know, it's just growth, you know.
And
I'm on 10.
What does Brandon
mm-hmm.
do when he's not performing or working?
That is how I really enjoy myself. I like to binge watch series. Oh, I like to write. We'll create, I guess. Well, I don't know. I just, that's all I do. That's literally all I do. I'll play basketball. Yeah, I'll hoop for fun. You know what I'm saying?
Do you have a girlfriend?
I do.
And how does she feel about watching you?
It's actually very funny because I met her on set.
Really? Your girlfriend is on the show too?
She was on background at the time.
Really?
Yeah. So she's not really fazed by like, cause she knows like I do my job, and that, you know, I do my job. I do it. I don't really do too much. Like, you know, I just make art be great. You know what I'm saying?
Anything embarrassing happened to you on the set?
Yeah. Let me tell you what happened. One day, I was coming from school. I didn't sleep because I had a midterm and I had to study for it, and I had like a couple assignments due, and so I didn't sleep. And so I had to be on set like 7-8 o'clock or whatever. And so I'm on set, and you know, we get dressed and you're shooting and all that stuff. And I'm sitting in the chair where we would just wait before we were called to set. And so I don't remember what happened, but I fell asleep. I was out, man. I was tired. And then all of a sudden, they all like pulling pranks on me, putting stuff on my head. And I actually posted that video on
Instagram. It's like, yo, welcome to the showbiz.
but it's fun. Like, my cast is like amazing. I love every single one of them. Like, we do that damn thing. You know what I'm saying? We do that happen. So yeah, it's really fun. I really enjoy it.
Once again, I thank you for coming on and joining us. You said you got an EP coming, which is name of the EP.
I don't have none of those details yet. All of that stuff I'm figuring out. I just know it's coming soon.
Okay, that's that millennial shit. See, millennials, they think they do the project, think last.
Yeah.
Like old times, they be like, yo, this is the name of the project, and then they go based on the name.
Yeah, no. Like, I really want to create an authentic vibe, right? Just create music, figure out which ones I like for real. Because I have some stored up, you know, I got some unreleased, you know what I'm saying?
Showtime Rhythm.
Yeah, man. Go listen to my last one, yeah?
Yeah. One for the rhythm, two for the ride, treating it ready as bobsled time. You got anything you want to say? How can people follow you?
I'm very glad for this. You know, I have a very unique name, Showtime Brando. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm the one and only. So you can find that on everything, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, all of that. Showtime Brando, you know. Yeah!
So New York. That is definitely New York. That is so New York. That Jamaican didn't even come out. That was just all New York just now. So ladies and gentlemen, once again, give it up for Showtime Brando. Make sure you can catch him every Sunday on Stars on P-Valley. DJ Never Scared.
Damn, is that my favorite host? Shyster talk of the town.